It's no femme. Oh my goodness, you can see his eyes. Okay, granted, yeah, you've been able to see Professor Ublek's eyes before. I mean, it's not like they're always hidden or something, but I mean, you can see them through the glasses. That doesn't normally happen. Anyways, yes, as I was saying, it's November. Specifically, it's the first Saturday of November, the 4th. Which means, since it's the first Saturday, that I have all my recording equipment here. And a dog trying to jump in so he can go and block the few of the recording equipment. Yes, hello, Matt. Hello. I know I'm the only one in the house, so you need to be with me. Everyone, say hello to Max, a dog who loves attention more than any other dog in the world. We took down our Halloween decorations today, so unfortunately, my yard, our yard, is a barren landscape with just some bushes and a tree and all, which is sad. I mean, granted, yeah, we're gonna be decorating for Christmas in like 3 weeks, because Thanksgiving is rather early this year compared to normal. But yeah, it's just sad to see the yard so barren. But, excuse me, my neighbors still have this like gravestone or something that whenever anything passes in front of it, like a leaf or anything, they'll start doing these like kind of. They'll just keep doing this recorded screaming. I don't know if you could hear on this phone, but it's rather annoying when it goes off at 3 in the morning, and then 3:02 in the morning, 3:05 in the morning, and then 3:07 sort of thing, because it keeps going off any time it detects any sort of motion. Yes. Oh, are you wanting a belly rub? Oh, I'm sorry. I haven't been paying enough attention to you. Yes. Ah, this poor dog. Okay, so I'm at North Star Mall, and I tried out this place behind me down there called Scooped. It's basically a cookie dough bar. Like, you know how like those ice cream places like Marble Slab or frozen yogurt places like Orange Leaf? It's basically that, but with cookie dough, and it's really good. And they have like all the stuff that's gone, and they've been pasteurized and everything, so you don't have to worry about salmonella, but it's cookie dough. Cookie dough. In a viable form. Just flat out cookie dough, you don't have to bake it or anything, it's delicious. So yeah, have you ever been to North Star Mall in San Antonio, this place back there called Scooped? It's really good. Okay, so didn't really want to have to talk too much today because I've had some post-nasal drip and I've had a sore throat for most of the day and it's not been fun. And yesterday I was coughing, I've been coughing a whole bunch, but I need to talk about this again because once again more gun violence has hit the nation, unfortunately, and this time it's about 30 minutes southeast of where I live. In a little town called Sutherland Springs. It's a town of about 400 people. That's only about it. That's about just a little small town of 400 people. And approximately 26, 27 people were gunned down there yesterday. And it's sad because it wasn't a church. It was a First Baptist church. And it was just people that were, they were doing what they do in a church. They were just worshiping. They were worshiping in the First Baptist church. And this person from another nearby town went and got a few guns, and just apparently he had been in the Air Force and he was dishonorably discharged because he was abusive to his wife, which shows just how great this person is. Excuse me. But he basically went and got some guns, and he went to, I mean, it was like, this guy was almost about my age, I think, like 26. He was just like a 26-year-old white male, which is, again, sadly, one of the most common, one of the more common, mo I don't know why it is, just, I honestly don't, but I mean, I've noticed how a lot of the mass shooters are white males, and I don't know why. I don't know the reason behind that, but it's just what I've noticed for the trends, so yeah. But yeah, I mean, he took a gun and he went up to this church and shot several of the people outside the church, started shooting through the windows, and then went into the church and just started shooting everyone. Just anyone he could shoot. He just decided just to go and just kill as many people as he could. And these people were just worshiping God, that's it. And it's sickening because I mean he I mean this church from what I heard, this church had maybe like 50 people, so he killed about half the membership of the church in this small little town of 400 people. It's just shaking up this whole place, this whole town. Excuse me, I mean this guy, they say apparently the oldest victim of this was 72 years old, but the youngest victim was 5. This guy killed a 5-year-old in cold blood. It's just sickening to think about. Another one of the, and even more sickening, another one of the people he killed was a pregnant woman. I mean, seriously, he didn't care about anything. He just wanted to kill people. He just felt that was the best thing to do. And he just went. He wasn't even from the area. He was from New Braunfels, I think, or something like that. Which is a shame, because that's usually a nice town. But he drove like 30 minutes to this place, if not more, just to go and kill a bunch of people, just because he just. We don't. No one knows that. No one knows the motive. I mean, the pastor for the church and his wife. The pastor of the church and his wife were not there that week, and there was someone else giving the sermon. I'm not entirely sure what they were doing. I think they were off doing something else with the church elsewhere. So they're still there, and they're still alive to help the church. But they had a 13 or 14-year-old daughter who was at the church, and she got killed too. So again, this a 13-year-old kid, alongside a 5-year-old kid, that this person just killed in cold blood, along with, I mean, he killed over 2 dozen people in cold blood just. For no reason whatsoever, just went in and killed them. For nothing, for no reason. Just. It's horrible to think about it. This is just it was just a small church of 50 people, and half of them had been killed in a small town of 400 people. That is just. They weren't ready for something like this. They didn't. No one ever wants something like this. And just. Again. Like I said last month, and many people are saying, we need better gun control. Okay, now obviously not everyone with a gun is going to be bad. Yes, I know that's the truth. In fact, in this case, when. Excuse me. In this case, actually, when the shooter was shooting up the church, two people nearby heard the shooter, grabbed their guns, and actually chased him off, like attacked the shooter. With their own guns and chased him out of the church, from what I heard, and they followed him down. Like he tried to escape the city, and they followed him down. And the shooter's dead. The shooter's dead, and they're not sure if the shooter killed himself or the two people that followed the shooter killed him. As I heard, though, the two people that followed him weren't facing any criminal issues or criminal charges right now, because I mean, they were going after the criminal. But yeah, I'm just. And I mean, the shooter's dead, but no one knows why he decided to do this. It's just sad. But again, we need better gun control. Obviously, yes. I mean, I we cannot ban, we cannot fully ban guns. That is going to be impossible in America here today. But I feel like we need to do something that like better checks the type of people that are getting these guns, like better background checks, more like maybe a mental health test they have to take. And repeatedly take every few years. Or maybe like a limit on how many guns someone can have and how much ammo someone can have. Just to go and better restrict these things. That's my idea at least. Because I mean I don't think we're going to be able to fully ban guns, but we need to put some sort of limit on them. Because we're really the only country where this repeatedly happens so often. I mean it does happen in every other country some, but not this much. And just. And of course, I mean, my senators are such wonderful people, like Ted Cruz, which are just like, as soon as people are trying to bring up, hey, are we going to do anything about this? Are we going to do anything about the bump stocks that caused even more of an issue in Las Vegas? And Ted Cruz is like, no, we can't, don't bring politics into this. He's like, we need to just go and focus on this and pray for these poor people. Don't bring politics into this issue. Well, thank you, Ted Cruz, the politician, for once again showing me why I'm going to not vote against, why I'm going to vote against you in your election next year. Because I want you out, because you have done so many bad things. He doesn't even believe climate change exists. He helped Trump to go and pull out of the Paris Climate Agreement, and then we have our former governor, Rick Perry. I don't know how he managed to be governor for so long. He's an idiot. He's all just like, oh, well, if Rick Perry just. He was like, oh, well, if we make more fossil fuels, we can go and bring more electricity to Africa, and that will brighten up Africa, and the sexual assault will go down. So, because of that, more fossil fuels being used reduces sexual assault. That is literally what Rick Perry is saying. The guy is a moron. And he actually did some good damage to our state. Like removing the law requiring motorcyclists to have helmets, which increased the fatalities of accidents involving motorcycles, and also did some pretty good damage to the education system. Tons of budget cuts, though. Yeah, thanks. Anyways, back to hand, yeah. For you, Ted Cruz, then, or anyone who's saying, no, we can't do anything about the politics or anything like that, it's too soon. Okay. Let me ask you then. Is it too soon for Las Vegas? Is it too soon for the Orlando nightclub? Is it too soon for that theater in Colorado? Is it too soon for Sandy Hook? Is it too soon for those? Because if that's the case, then why don't we act on those? Because this has gone down as the deadliest mass shooting in Texas in modern history. Anyone know how bad this is now? Remember Columbine back in the late 90s? That one that was such a huge tragedy? And still is today? It's not even in the top 10 worst mass shootings in America anymore. We've managed to outdo Columbine 10 times. This needs to stop. We need better gun control now, or else we are going to just continue to have dozens of innocent lives lost every month due to maniacs with guns. Now, again, yes, not everyone with a gun is bad, obviously, but we still need to do something about those that are. Anyways, I'm done. Let's just move on to the next scene. Hey, so guess what finally happened? After a few people got it about a month or two ago, Twitter has finally given everyone the ability to do 280 characters per tweet. Which is, it's a mixed bag. I mean, it's interesting because that way you don't have to go, and if you're doing like a thread or if you're trying to use tweet longer, you don't have to use it as much because you can go and fit more into each individual tweet. At the same time, though, it does feel like a part of Twitter has been lost. Because those 140 characters were, well, part of what made Twitter Twitter, having to go and try to fit your thoughts into 140 characters while still having it make sense. Okay, so it's been an uneventful week for the most part, just me struggling with allergies and everything, and post-nasal drip killing me repeatedly. It sucked, but yeah. But I'm out and about today because I've come to pick up this. So yes, I have Mifa, which I pre-ordered from Best Buy, and I thought I could have sworn I went and selected the ship to my house option, but apparently I selected the pickup in store option. So yeah, I have Mifa. The other three champions are on the way. It's just the fact that I pre-ordered them from Walmart, like back in July or so. Well, shortly after they were first revealed, I pre-ordered them. But when I pre-ordered them from Walmart, I wasn't able to get Mifa. I wasn't actually able to get Mifa until like the end of October when I finally was able to get one from Best Buy. She eluded me for a while though, so yeah. So the other three are on the way. That's just going to be sometime this afternoon or in a couple of days. So yeah. Still, the Champion Amiibo are going to be mine now. So that's more to add to my collection, which just means that until they reveal new Amiibo, which you know Nintendo's going to do, until they do that, it's going to just be me trying to find the Skyward Sword Link Amiibo for cheap. Which, given the scalpers, is not going to be very easy. Peaceful and quiet, minus the rumble of the road off in the distance. What can I say? City parks are nice.
Here we go. Comanche Lookout Park here is the fourth tallest point in the city of San Antonio, elevation-wise, and gives you quite the view. I remember it was this view that gave me... It was this view that kind of marked the start of a new point in the vlog here. Well, I was out doing things and not just sitting around at a table talking about something once a month. And you know, it all just kind of happened on accident because I kind of admittedly forgot to do the recording for the vlog that I was supposed to. And I had to go take Max for a walk that day, so I was like, you know what, let's just go walk in the park and talk to the camera while walking the dog, just multitask sort of thing. And I just kind of liked the way it turned out, and I just continued doing it. Sometimes the best things happen by accident, but yeah, let's see if we can zoom in here a little bit and see. I don't know how well you can see, but downtown is there off in the distance. The airport's over off in that direction here. The north side of the city is over that way, or far northeast side. This park is actually more on the edges of the city, and there's another hill over there. Though it's filled up with houses and businesses, but it's about the same size as Comanche Lookout Hill. Might be the fifth tallest point, or maybe even the third tallest point in the city. But yeah, and there's a busy road down there called Nacogdoches. Though it does not lead to the city called Nacogdoches, Texas. That's a bit further away. Okay, so I'm at a baby shower, which is the first time I've been at one since my sister was born, and she just turned 21. So that tells you how long it's been since I've been at a baby shower. But yeah, I'm at a baby shower for a couple of friends. And yeah, I mean, the father-to-be I've known since I was in fourth grade, and the mother-to-be I've known since I was in like first grade. So I've known these people for a long time, like some of the longest people I've known in my whole life outside of my family. But it's just surreal. This is kind of like a weird feeling that these people I've known since I was a kid or getting married and having a kid together. It's just wow. So yeah, just another sign I'm getting old. I mean, I'm only 26, but still, I feel my age. But yeah, it's cool. I'm happy for them. Oh, time to have some fun. There you go, Justin and Sarah. There you go. Hope you enjoy this. Okay, a baby food eating contest to try to guess the flavor. I'm gonna have to have words with the father-to-be here. Price is Right guessing game over there was a good idea, though I have no clue what the prices were, but this, yeah. What am I doing with my life? I guess that this flavor is vegetable pumpkin mush with a hint of squash. Alright, so it's one day later here now, Monday the 13th of November, and I'm at a place called Rolling Oaks Mall, just coming in the back entrance here, because I have to go and pick up some stuff for my part-time seasonal job, namely new work pants, because all the ones I have are either have holes in them, have cargo pockets, or blue jeans, or multiple of the above. So yeah, I need new work pants for the place I'm going to work at, so yeah. Rolling Oaks Mall has some nice stuff for a good price. It's a nice mall that's not like too fancy like a few of the other ones, like the one North Star I went to earlier this month. It's a nice mall, it just has like the fancy shops. Like, I mean, it has like a few places like Hot Topic and stuff that's normal, but like a lot of the really fancy shops, and I can't really afford the fancy shops all too well, so yeah. Nordstrom Mall is a good place for affordable clothes. I just said Nordstrom. Rolling Oaks Mall. Rolling Oaks Mall is a good place for affordable clothing, so yeah. And unfortunately, I wasn't able to go and actually really talk. I mean, I was able to talk to my friends yesterday at the baby shop, but I wasn't able to really get anything for them on YouTube, so I will get them, so you know who I'm talking about. It's just gonna be a few more days. Okay, short while later, took out my shopping. Thank you, Macy's, for having what I needed. Had a good price too, so yeah. Also, this random question. Has anyone ever, I mean, I am assuming almost everyone here has eaten M&M's at some point in their life, but has anyone here ever eaten a M&M that is kind of melted? Like an M&M where the chocolate inside has melted, but the candy coating shell is still intact? Because those are so good. Like, obviously you don't really have them that often because when you buy a bag of M&M's, they're not melted, but I mean, like, an M&M, well, the M&M is, like, the chocolate melted inside, but the candy coating shell is still intact. It's delicious because you have all the wonderful flavor of an M&M. But when you bite that candy coating shell, all the melted chocolate just, like, splashes out over your tongue. It's so good. So good. I recommend it sometime. Where are you, Max?
Hello.
Yes. I've decided... Oh, yes. Hello. Oh, yes. He's on my arm. I decided this vlog doesn't have enough dog in it. So, here we go, Max. I'm taking him to another park for a walk here today, instead of just roaming around the neighborhood, so... He's excited and happy, aren't you, Max? Ready to go for a walk? Ready to go for a walk? Oh yeah, he's ready to go for a walk, of course. You doing alright, Max? Just trying to figure out what to sniff? Going everywhere, from left to right to left? Sniffing everything that your little nose can handle. Anyways, beautiful place this is indeed. This place I've taken Max to today is called Brackenridge Park. And you may have heard of it because it's basically like the city park of San Antonio here. And Max is just happily sniffing away here. But I mean, like, this place has... Max, can't go too far off the trail, okay, dog? Okay, boy? Of course, you don't know that, you just want to sniff. But yeah, I mean, this place has the San Antonio Zoo, the Brackenridge Eagle, which I've actually had on my channel before, back in like 2014. It has the San Antonio Tea Gardens, the San Antonio Japanese Tea Gardens, the... Let's see, there's several baseball fields, a driving range as well. There's an animal shelter here now as well. At Trinity University, just on the other side of 281. The Witte Museum, which is a natural and human history museum about the state of Texas, pretty much. It's right on the border of the park. Did I say baseball fields? Because there are baseball fields here. Plenty of them. So yes, there's a lot to do in this park, and there even used to be things like, I mean, there's also walking trails as well, and the San Antonio River. Can't forget the San Antonio River. San Antonio River runs through this park just south of its springs. And let's see, yeah. So we're in this little section of the San Antonio River between its spring and the world-famous River Rock that it flows through. So yeah, and there also used to be things like boat rides here, but those were gone before I was born. And then also a little cable car skylift between the zoo and the tea gardens that was around back when I was a kid, but sadly they tore it down a long time ago. There's also random sculptures here, like this weird log thing. Behold, Max, the San Antonio River. Flowing slowly, it's a small river up here. Oh, whoops, I stepped on a branch. What do you think, Max, or do you not care? You're just sniffing everywhere. Ah, the beauty of nature. Downtown is that direction. And the springs on that direction. And there's a road right behind me. Oh, construction equipment. Yeah, they're working on some sections of the park. There's a few playgrounds that are getting some repairs done, and a few older structures here that have been around for decades upon decades that are getting some renovations done to them. Do you see the ducks over there, Max? Do you see the ducks over there? Do you? Or do you? You don't care, do you? You're just looking around looking for things to smell, aren't you? Well, his tail's wagging. So he's out. Oh. I tried to show it, and then he turned around. Yeah, just a bunch of ducks just hanging out in the river. There's a few stone walls along the river up here, but it's just nice and peaceful. Some pavilions for picnicking over there. The outskirts of the zoo in the distance. There's also this road here called Tulito or Tuleto or whatever that you can actually drive through the river here on. I mean, it's actually open right now. Wait, no, it's closed. I can see the gate over there. It's closed, so you can't drive in it. It's open only during specific times when, like, the river conditions are just right for you to be able to drive through it. But it's kind of cool when you can. Did you have a nice walk, Max? Did you? Yes, yes, oh yes, I mentioned your name, so you're getting my face now, yes. Anyways, yes, Max is happy. He's thirsty, but he won't drink the water here, because you're being weird. I mean, I love him, but I went to one of those little communal dog, like the water fountains that have the water fountain on the ground so the dogs can drink it. I went to one of those, I activated the water for him, and he just sat there and sniffed around the water bowl, sniffed around the water fountain, and then didn't drink any water. I literally, like, I held him and, like, made him look at the water. Just be like, Max, you need to drink this because I know you're really thirsty right now. And he literally, like, looked at the water. He sniffed the water, saw that it was water. And then you didn't drink the water. You refused to because it's not your water dish. Like, come on, Max. Like, please. And then you were trying to drink water off the ground earlier. Why didn't you want to drink water from the water dish? Most I can figure is because he doesn't like other dogs that much, and it smelled like other dogs, so he refused to have anything to do with it. But I really don't understand that dog sometimes. None of us do. So yeah. Okay. So, first day on the new job, finally. It's only a 4-hour shift, but I'm nervous. Yeah, I'm nervous. Doesn't help that I had a dream last night where I was at a job that the manager was giving me, like, all these crazy, like, demands and requests that I had to go and take care of too. So yeah, that wasn't fun, but hopefully this will go well. At least that was the first part of the dream. The second part of the dream, I went Christmas shopping, and I went to a mall that for some reason all the escalators all the down escalators have been turned into roller coasters. But like, they weren't like roller coasters. Like, basically you still had to just hold on to the handrail for the escalator, and the escalator just went like up and down crazy like a roller coaster. It was weird. And then my dream tried to turn into the Stanley Parable. But that's besides the point. The point is, I had probably a stress-related dream due to being nervous about this new job. So that was fun. That was fun, yeah. But like I said, only 4-hour shift today. Yeah, it starts in 20 minutes, and the job's right over there, so I'm just killing a little bit of time before I go in, like 10 minutes before I go in. So yeah, just wish me the best of luck here. Retroactively, of course. Okay, there we go. First shift is done. And it was a lot of walking, which is good. I need the exercise. I'm rather thirsty though, so I came to a gas station afterwards to get something to drink. But yeah, I don't really have to go and interact with the customers too much, which is good because I'm sociable. It's just that I'm socially awkward sociable. So yeah, not having to interact with the customers is good, because basically all I have to do really is I'm taking care of the online orders, or like the people who have placed orders online for pickup in store or delivery to their houses. That's what I'm taking care of. So I'm kind of more working behind the scenes often. So yeah, that's good.
I must say that there is a very good size box for containing only the Skyward Sword Link amiibo. Like, seriously, Amazon, what the heck? You couldn't have picked, like, any smaller box than that big one? Like, I seriously thought that was containing the Final 3 Champion amiibo, because Mipha is just... she's been chilling over there with the Ruby figurines, waiting on the other three champions to finally show up for Momo. But, yeah, okay. Giant box for one amiibo. Huh. Oh, suck it, scalpers. I got this for the price of a normal amiibo, not your $60 not your rip off $60 prices that you are going and trying to make people pay for this. So yeah. Okay, so check this out here. This is the box Amazon used to deliver one amiibo. As you can see, it is very much bigger than the other box. This smaller box is the box that Walmart used to deliver three amiibo. One, three. Come on, Amazon, you can do better than that. I still don't get why they use that big of a box. And then Walmart uses, like, a box like... Look how small this box is compared to the other one. This was three amiibo compared to one amiibo. Am I freaking you out, Max? Like, every single time, like, I hit a box, he... well, not that time, but, like, all the other times, he, like, kind of flinched a little. You okay? Or are you just happy that you just got back from a walk? And there we go. Oh, the champions. And for the heck of it, I put them next to the member of Team Ruby I think fits them the best. And yes, I feel Ruby would be kind of more a combination of Link and Zelda, while Yang gets to be both Daruk and Urbosa. I mean, yeah, these aren't like 100% matches, but I mean, just what I feel like. But yeah, I have all the champion amiibo now. Okay, it's 11:07, and I just want you all to know that if the vlog skips ahead by several days from this point, it's because this game just came out here. So yeah, time to go through the Alola region once again.
So my parents and I went up to New Braunfels here to go and look at these lights in the little traffic circle at the heart of town here. Set up the Christmas lights already. It's actually very nice. Courthouse over there is absolutely decorated with lights. The camera's not really focusing that well on them. It's night and the lights are messing with it. And New Braunfels, old Germantown, has a nice classic downtown to it as well, plus a nice park in that direction called Lander Park. So yeah. Oh, just here in the middle of a traffic circle. Just beautiful lights, nice little gazebo, a few statues, a Christmas tree over in that direction. Just a nice little area. It's kind of hard to tell on the camera, but basically what they did here is they strung the lights up from the edges to the center, but then they added a bunch of lights just kind of hanging down in the center. That's what the bright, massive lights you see there is. Maybe you can show up if I zoom in. Nah, the camera can't really capture the effect that well. Darn.
Do you smell that? Because if you do, I want to know what technology you're using to be able to smell that, seriously. But no, what I'm smelling is the smell of a Thanksgiving dinner, almost ready to be eaten. With delicious turkey, mashed potatoes, yams, and green beans, plus more. My dad's a really good cook, he spoils us, so yeah. So yes, happy Thanksgiving, everyone, in post, obviously, since you're seeing this in, like, December. But still, yes, it's going to be Thanksgiving. My sister's home from college for now. So my mom, dad, sister, and I, and Max, all just relaxing for today and having a nice Thanksgiving dinner. Okay, now, since it's time for some wonderful, delicious pumpkin pie, and we've been eating it a lot, as you can see, it's time to show you the proper way to eat a piece of pumpkin pie. First, take the pumpkin pie out and put it on a plate. Then what you need to do is apply a small amount of whipped cream. Then once you've applied the small amount of whipped cream, you should go and maybe put something on top of it, like a nice little cherry or something. I personally am not the biggest fan of cherry, so I instead substitute it for a little bit of whipped cream. And there you go. The proper way to eat a slice of pumpkin pie. Look at that delicious goodness.
Okay, since it's the day after Thanksgiving, we spent today eating leftovers, but also starting to decorate for Christmas here, since I'm going to be working tomorrow, so we took today to decorate instead. So yeah, this is what we're doing this year. Bunch of candy canes up in the tree, you can't really see all of them, but they're there. Yeah, might put something in the middle of the yard here. We ended up going and having to get rid of a lot of our old decorations because they just worn out over the years. Or a few of them, actually. We plugged them in and they were dead. The wires were all frayed and everything was just done for. But I do like what we have. Okay, well, the camera's not really doing that good a job of focusing, but this is our Christmas tree here. In the dark, so you can go and see the nice lights a bit better. With many different ornaments. Maybe I'll show this again during the day so you can see the ornaments a bit better, but we have things like stars, snowmen, snowflakes, trains, definitely a lot of trains thanks to me, reindeer, bears, animals, superheroes. There's a tortoise on here somewhere as well. It's a very nice, very filled tree with a lot of nice ornaments on it, both on the outside and the inside. Wait, is that working now? Whatever. How does film in darkness? Excuse me, because it's like 5:45 in the morning. And it's winter, so the sun hasn't risen yet at all. But yeah, no, this is it's because my work shift starts at 6 a.m. and this is not really agreeing with my wrecked sleep schedule. Though this might be a great way to go and
like easily fix it, because I'm pretty sure I'm not going to be able to stay up till midnight tonight, because I had to wake up at 4:15 in the morning to be able to get here on time. But yeah, my shift starts in like 15 minutes. I'm already here at my work, so yeah, it's just like, well, so you can see parking lot lights off in the distance there, though you can have something you can see. But yeah, oh, I mean, this is my first 4 8-hour shift here. At least I get a little like hour-long break in there as well, but just like, yeah, this is going to be interesting being here so early and also before the store opens. So yeah, okay, work shift is done. And well, yeah, it was a bit hectic because the system crashed a few times. Not the system overall, but just the system that I'm using for fulfilling the online orders. So that was a bit hectic, but apparently it crashed completely on Black Friday or something. Like, the credit card machines went down on Black Friday. So yeah, I'm thankful I wasn't there for that. I'm also thankful for the fact that I didn't have to work on Thanksgiving or Black Friday, instead just the Saturday after. So yeah, I have a few days I'm working next week. Other than that, I don't know. Just looking for jobs, pretty much. Just looking for a full-time job to just continue my architectural career. Continue and move on with my architectural career. But for now, home. And potentially a movie as well. I think my family wants to see Thor Ragnarok tonight.
Okay, so in the end, we didn't go see Thor Ragnarok. I felt okay while I was at work, but when I was driving home, I guess sitting down for an extended period of time allowed the fact that I had woken up at like 4:15 in the morning to hit me pretty hard, and I was tired. Became very tired indeed. And yeah, it wasn't fun driving home, because I just started becoming very drowsy and started losing. I made it home just fine, thankfully, but yeah, I was starting to get exhausted. And turns out my sister, since she's home for the weekend from college, she had to deal with our dog Max, who apparently had a long, like hour and a half long coughing fit last night. So yeah, we're having to go and take care of him to see what's going on with that, but that kept her up, so we were both tired. So instead, we just went out for dinner to a place called Matt Anger's, I do believe it's called, because it's founded by a couple named Matt and Anger. But yeah, it's really good pizza, really delicious pizza, and it's like some of the best calzones I've ever had. So yeah, if you're ever in the, it's not in San Antonio, but if you're ever in the San Antonio area, it's a cool place to go and try out. Yeah. Would you look at that? My dad got a few new decorations for the yard here with Rudolph and the Bumble, which is nice. It fills in the gap between the ornaments there and the decorations up there and decorations back there. So that's cool. Nice little addition to the yard he made.
So yeah, I'm at a discount aisle now. Well, okay, I'm leaving the discount aisle now, but yeah,
I have the low tire pressure
icon on my dashboard here come on. Well, it's off now, but it came on, and I looked around my tires to see which one it was, and found out there was a nail in the left front tire that was causing my tire to slowly leak out. So I came here, tried to get a patch job. Unfortunately, it was like right in that spot, like right on the edge of the tire, so they couldn't properly patch it because it was too close to the wall of the tile. So I ended up having to get a whole new tile. Thankfully, past me made a smart move and made it so I had a warranty on the tile, so I only had to pay like $18 to get a new tile as opposed to like $300. So yeah, thank you past me for being smart about something. Thank you so much. Okay, I'm glad I did that. So yeah, new tile on my car, everything's running fine here. So yeah, just I'll drive around a bit, break the tire in, and then just probably head home. Work on YouTube videos.
Okay, I'm kind of annoyed here, because my computer, for whatever reason, I mean, my computer has this little thing right here. This is a fingerprint scanner. I can use it to sign into my computer instead of having to use a password or a PIN.
I do have a password and PIN set up. I just use a fingerprint scanner. But my computer, for whatever reason, has forgotten that it has the ability to use a fingerprint scanner for the sign-in. And it did this 6 months ago, too. And I don't remember how I fixed it then to fix it now. And I'm just wondering why the heck it just forgot it to begin with. Like, I don't know. Just like, I mean, like, see, I have the ability to go and I have the password. I have the PIN, picture password and stuff. I don't use the picture password or the Windows Hello, but it's just not there. I mean, I can just go and go to home, go to find setting, just be like fingerprints, let it search. And you'll have sign-in options and set up fingerprint sign-in. I'll click that. And, oh look, I'm back here. Except there's no fingerprint sign-in option for absolutely no reason. And as far as I've seen, just turning it off and back on again does not fix the problem. So what the heck is wrong with my computer here? Great, I know what I'm doing this evening. Besides editing videos, joy. Just, I don't get what happened. It's just weird and really annoying. Well, that's it. That's pretty much all there is for this vlog for November. So this is Gotablaze. I hope you enjoyed this vlog, and I will see you all next month. So long, everyone.